Welcome back. You're listening to Racer Radio right here on AM 1170.
The Answer.
This segment is brought to you by El Cajon Ford. El Cajon Ford, where nobody, absolutely nobody, treats you better. 1595 East Main Street in El Cajon. Take a run down there. That's a racing dealership. Paul Dyke runs out there. His kids run out there. And they support Barona Circle Track 110%. BaronaSpeedway.com for all the latest scheduling and updates. Need to support your local track, because once those tracks are gone, folks, they'll never, ever come back. Hey, we got John Isabella on the line. John, how are you today, sir?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Did you take a break from working on the race car? I have a sneaky feeling.
And just today. I was up there yesterday working off like 8 hours.
See, I told you.
Yep.
So you're the expert when it comes to every track in the area. What, with a 500-mile radius?
Yeah, I think the furthest we went was Medford, Oregon. I think that was like close to 900 miles one way.
Wow.
And how long did you stay there?
We drove up Thursday and came home Sunday. Ended up getting home Monday morning.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So it is this race. Now, do you do this for a living? Do you race dwarf cars for a living, or do you have a real job?
No, I got a real job. This is just a hobby. We've always loved racing, so
sure.
Just a hobby.
Have you always been in the dwarf series?
No, I started out back in 2000, running the Allison Legacy Series on asphalt, and then we jumped over to legend cars for another couple years, and then I went on like an 8-year break and did the desert stuff, and then we got back into racing. So, now we've been in it for, I think, 4 years now.
Didn't you love the Allison series with Stu Peace?
It was great. It was great. Yeah, Stu owned the car that I drove.
I know. I reached out to be Facebook friends, and son of a gun, there was his car right on your, I looked at your photos. I went, I know that car. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I was very fortunate for the first 4 years or so that I drove for other people. Matt Hicks owned the legend car,
right.
Matthew's dad that you know, and his parents owned the legend car, and Stu owned the legacy car.
Wow. Yeah, he let me drive it one time, and man, if you didn't know any better, you were in a full-blown NASCAR, just a little bit smaller.
Yeah, it was very fun, very competitive.
I think so, too. It was a spec car, Mazda truck motor with a tranny, all sealed, but man, was it a hoot. I love that series. So have you kind of found a home in the dwarf car series?
Well, Barona's my closest track. It's like 30-35 minutes away from my house.
Yeah.
But I like to travel. I mean, I like to, one thing about going to all these different tracks is every track is different, and it just challenges you to try to figure that track out and do well that night. And you only have a heat race in the main event to figure it out.
Yeah. So, well, you got a pretty nice.
That's what I like.
Yeah, you got a pretty nice rig, I might add. I just happened to see that on your post as well. So if you're going to travel, that's the way to travel.
Yeah, that's a nice truck.
Yeah, it's a real nice truck. I mean, you probably can't wait to just go drive it just to go drive it.
Yeah, normally about once a week I take it out, and then it sits the rest of the week till racing.
So how old is your boy?
He's 3 and a half now.
Geez. Do you think he's going to get the bug?
I hope so. I mean, just keep him busy and, hopefully he likes it. He loves it now. I mean, we go out, re-race and stuff, and he's in the pits. I mean, that's all part of it. Having your family there, that's the biggest thing to me. Is I will not go race somewhere if my wife and kid can't go.
Right. Oh, how cool is that? Well, Holly Henry. You know the Henrys.
Yes.
Yeah, same thing. I mean, her and her kids, what does she call her kids?
Shake and bake.
Shake and bake. What a thing to call, what a thing to call your kids. But it's the same thing. And I've been involved with Cajon Speedway back in the day. And, you go into the pits and you always seen the family. Just like Barona. And that's what I try to tell people. You need to go up to Barona and go into the pits. I mean, goodness gracious, they're barbecuing, they're having fun, and they're getting cars ready. And you're right. It's just a really big family operation. That's what I like about it.
Exactly.
So I always have to ask people this. And I don't want to forget. Who you got on the side of the car that helps pay the bills?
Well, my brother, he's J.I. Coatings. He owns a painting business. Okay. And my lifelong friend, Richard Holman, he owns R&R Construction Plumbing. two great businesses that do very well. And then Shane and Angel Rosson, they own D&R Chassis and Rosson Racing. They helped me out a ton, and that's where I was yesterday for 8 hours working in Shane's shop, you know, fixing the truck. And my buddy Dustin Dumas, he's a local guy right here. He owns AG Sand Cars right here in El Cajon, and a great fabricator and aluminum work. And then my buddy Ryan Diotti, he actually lives all the way up in San Jose, California, but he travels to a lot of the races, and we hang out, and he helps me a lot. With shocks and setup and advice, and he's just an all-around great guy. So,
well, I tell you what. Yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry.
I was going to say my parents, of course, they help me out with the support. They come to the track as much as they possibly can, and my buddy Gordon and Richard, they help out when they can, and Mike Mendenhall, which you know that name from Cajon, and Matt Hicks.
Good old Mikey.
And, and then my lovely wife, Tanya, and my son Cody.
Well, you know what more? You couldn't complain. I mean, it sounds like you're just having a great time.
Yeah. I mean, all these people, they love to do it, and they love to help out any way they can. I mean, they can either help me on building product, help me here in the garage, or they give me some of their hard-earned money to go have a great time.
Exactly. Yeah. It sounds like so you're going to stay in the Dwarf Series? You're going to be running for sure on 2018?
Yeah. I'm hoping to make the Canyon race. That's in Arizona. They always have a winter classic. I went the last 2 years, and we've been fortunate enough to win two out of the four races. So I think we finished second in the other two, but that's what I'm shooting for, the end of January to get back in it, if I can get the car back together and ready to roll.
So January.
Yeah, what's wrong with the car?
At the last national, we went to Marysville in September. Car spun in front of us, and we hit them pretty good and bent the front clip over a little bit. So I ran. The funny thing was, after that, we kept running races, and we're still competing for the wins after it was bent. So we straightened it out, so hopefully it's even faster.
Yeah, it does. It always runs better when it's straight.
Right.
Funny thing how that is, huh?
So, yeah, no kidding.
So how'd you do last season?
Last season went good. I told myself last season I would not run for any point series at a track besides the national point series. Every year, the Western States Dwarf Car Association puts on a four-race national series. So that's why we travel all over from Quincy, California to Medford to Merced and all that. Mm-hmm. But we finished second in the national points. So that was a great accomplishment.
Wow.
And, congratulations.
Thank you. So, but here at the tracks, I didn't run for points. We went all the way over to Arizona, Northern California, Verona here. I wanted to do it just for fun this year.
Sure. So, well, I tell you what, I tell everybody this. If you want to load up the race car once you get it straight and drag it to KUSI just to give a little love back to your sponsors, all you got to do is send me an email, and I'll be more than happy to schedule a date that works for you. You bring the wife, the kids, the parents, all your advertisers. We'll come to KUSI, and we'll just do a segment on you and your car.
Cool. That'd be awesome.
Well, because when you go out looking for, if you ever start looking for more ad dollars or, you know, sponsorship dollars, it's nice when you tell them, hey, if you sponsor me, I can get you on the number one watch morning show in San Diego. And the only motorsport show in San Diego on radio. So, and I'm more than happy to, because I'm a big supporter of small tracks. I hate it when I drive by Cajon Speedway to this day and it's still empty. And if I go to a track like Paris Auto Speedway, and I've run into Agajanian because he's one of the big promoters. When I know I'm going, I always wear a Cajon Speedway jacket or a hat, and I go up and I point at my jacket and say, "Don't let this happen to this track." And I've done it to the Salazars as well, because it doesn't take much to lose. And once you lose it, you'll never get it back.
Yeah, that is the downfall. I mean, you see tracks closing here and there, and, yeah, they never reopen. Even El Centro is one of them. They only, here and there, they'll run a race.
Yeah.
But otherwise, it's not there.
Yeah, and it is. It is super, super, super sad. But anyway, you know, we just got to keep it going, and we got to keep get people to come out to the track. And Verona is such a fun track. I mean, you got a great announcer in Dirt Dude. He loves what he does with minimal amount of equipment. Gets a really, you know, job well done, and I'm sure you know Brittany.
Yes. Yeah, Brittany. She's a great gal. She
isn't she?
She's always great spirits around the pit.
I hate to think what's going to happen one day when she wins a race. You know what? They're going to have to clear out Barona because you know she's going to she'll tear that place down. If she ever wins a race, that'll be the greatest day in her life, I got a feeling.
I just hope we're there to see it.
Well, I think she's going to get it. She's going to get a win. You wait.
I think she might lose her voice in the first 4.5 minutes because she's going to be screaming so much.
Oh, heck
she is a screamer.
Heck, she does
do that. Nope. But I mean, because I think last year, I think the best she did was either third or second or third. So, I mean, she's getting there. I think it's just more seat time, and the help from you guys, because I know everybody in that series really, not just her, but you guys will help anybody in your series just to get everybody on the track.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and that's the fun part. You guys may not be the best of friends on the track, but you're definitely the best of friends off the track.
It's the sportsmanship.
Sure. Absolutely. And when she puts all her gear on, she looks just like the rest of you, just a little lighter.
Yeah.
She doesn't eat as much, I don't think, if she eats at all.
She does. Yeah. She just makes sure she has a racer's figure.
Yeah, she has a racer figure, that's for sure. So, all right. Okay, well, hey, again, thank you very much for taking time calling in. We appreciate it. I'll send a copy off to Brittany, and she can get you a copy of this, and you can hang on to it for those days when you get really old and you want to listen back on how well you did.
I wanted to know, before we go, what do you have number 12 on your car? What does it mean?
Back when I was 11 or 12 years old, when I met Mike Mendenhall and Matt Hicks, they lived down the street from my dad. So they took me in when I was real young and just started off, you know, just sweeping the floors. And then finally I got to jump in the car and help them bleed brakes. And, you know, and then so I've known them, you know, most of my life. And they're the ones who took me in. So the number 12 is from Mike and Matt's race car that, you know, I thought it had a great meaning. So that's why I chose it.
Sure.
Okay. But so that's my reason behind the 12 is because of him.
Okay, now when you get done, call Mike Mendenhall up and said, "Hey, I mentioned you, and I mentioned your car, and I mentioned your number. So send me $100. See if you get it. Tell him I said so. Tell him I said so.
That's how it works.
Hey, I'll give it a shot.
Hey, if anything, you'll get a good chuckle out of him. Watch, he'll turn around and say, "Wait a minute, Stahl owes me $100.
Say, here's 12 cents because it's number 12.
All right, buddy.
There you go.
Hey, well, let's set up for KUSI. I'd love to get you down and get the car on there, and no pressure. As soon as you get it done, just reach out.
I appreciate that. One last thing is I'd just like to thank all the men and women of our military and our armed forces, our police, our fire department, our paramedics that keep us safe every day.
Awesome.
Absolutely. Yes. Amen, brother. Thank you, and Merry Christmas to you and your family.
All right. Merry Christmas to you guys. Have a good day.
All right,
thanks,
buddy.
Thanks, John. All right.